Good morning. Today we start with first law analysis of engine cycle. Before a detailed thermodynamic analysis of the engine cycle is done, we will draw the energy balance so that one becomes familiar with the various performance parameters. In this figure, energy flow through reciprocating engine is explained. According to first law of thermodynamics, energy can neither be created nor destroyed. It can only be converted from one form of to another form. Therefore, there must be an energy balance between input and output of the system. In reciprocating internal combustion engine, the fuel is fed into the combustion chamber. Fuel is fed into the combustion chamber and after that it burns in air, converting chemical energy of fuel into heat. The liberated heat energy cannot be totally utilized for driving the piston. Whatever energy is produced here in the combustion chamber, the whole energy cannot be utilized to push the piston downward. So there are some losses through the engine exhaust. So there are some energy losses through the engine exhaust by the coolant, because we use coolant to cool down the engine block. So there are some losses. Some part of that fuel energy is taken by coolant. Radiation is also one of the loss. Some amount of energy of this fuel is lost in the form of radiation. The heat energy which is converted to power at this stage is called integrated power. So whatever the heat energy is converted into power at the piston surface is called integrated power. So whatever energy converted, whatever heat energy is converted at the piston surface to power is called integrated power. And it is used to drive the piston. The energy represented by the gas forces on the piston passes through the connecting rod to the crankshaft. In this transmission, there are energy losses due to bearing friction and pumping losses, etc. So whatever indicated power here is not transferred fully to the crankshaft. Some amount of energy is lost in between because of the friction between piston and cylinder, between bearing. Okay, so there are energy losses in transmission, energy losses in the form of friction, pumping losses and uncounted losses. So what I am saying is, whatever energy, whatever power here is indicated power, but during transmission there are some losses. So whatever power we are getting at the crankshaft is called brake power. Whatever power we will get here at the crankshaft, which is the actual output, is called brake power. Is called brake power. And ratio of brake power to indicated power is called mechanical efficiency. The ratio of brake power which we get at shaft and to the ratio of indicated power which we get at piston, this ratio is called mechanical efficiency. So this energy balance, generally friction power is not shown separately, because ultimately this energy is accounted in exhaust, cooling water and radiation. If there is a friction between piston and cylinder, either this friction will go as a heating, or this friction will go, whatever heat is produced will be taken by coolant, or there is a wear and tear. So generally we don't take friction. We will include friction in these losses, energy losses. Whatever friction, okay. So this is the complete energy flow through reciprocating engine. This is complete diagram, energy flow through the reciprocating engine, okay. So next, after this, we will discuss the new topic, engine performance parameters.